Hey, I realized that there was a time I painted Notre-Dame de Paris Cathedral on location and shot it for you that I didn't get the chance to share yet. And I think this may be the perfect time to share. I hope nobody will think and say that I am exploiting a drama or that there are more serious dramas in the world, unfortunately, and that we don't need all this fuss. This video is just an homage to the work of the firefighters who managed to save the monument and my tribute to one of the most magnificent and symbolic monument in the world, among hundreds of other treasures in our world heritage that we should cherish and protect, but also never forget or tire to admire, enhance and create from.
Oh Notre-Dame, laisse-moi rien qu'une fois glisser mes doigts dans les cheveux d'Esmeralda.
I know that suits her well. When she dances, all the stories she can tell. A free bird trying out her wings to fly away. And when I see her move, I see hell to pay. She dances naked in my soul and sleep won't come. And it's no use to pray these prayers to Notre Dame. Tell who'd be the first to raise his hand and throw a stone. I'd hang him high and laugh to see him die alone. Oh Lucifer, please let me go beyond God's law and run my fingers through her hair to smear out.
And to see and to sketch Notre-Dame de Paris so often, and that's a real pleasure to be able to share this with you. So in this video you will see me painting Notre-Dame on location, watercolor, urban sketching, and I will also share with you and review several sketches I did of Notre-Dame de Paris over the years. So last Monday on April the 15th, Notre-Dame de Paris got on fire. In the flames for hours, the cathedral lost its whole roof and its sumptuous spike and kept burning. For several hours, France, along with the whole world, wondered if the whole cathedral would collapse and if Paris would lose one of the most iconic elements of its skyline, its silhouette, Notre-Dame two squared towers. Around 11 p.m., they at last announced that Notre-Dame de Paris main structure may be saved. What a relief. I couldn't imagine Paris without it. I think reviewing my art that night, sharing it and making these doodles in my journal from photos the day after was a way to acknowledge and process the event. I think we shouldn't underestimate the power of art and crafts as a way to experience the world and process life. Likewise, on that gorgeous sunny day of November last year, I used my creative technique to try to grasp a vision, an architectural identity, an atmosphere. First, I used my Foudenib fountain pen and did this ink sketch of Notre Dame that I shared in another video. Then I decided for an experiment, a kinda abstract sketchy watercolor of the iconic cathedral. The idea was trying to enhance its graphical presence, a straight linear structure bearing gothic laces. And afterwards, I realized how much the technique I used followed this architectural analysis and breaking down a structure, as I started with a flat brush and negative painting to create the angular silhouette of the main tower on the blue sky. Then I went from the flat brush to the third liner to evoke the inside divisions of the monument and the lacy embellishments. At last, I used my pointed round to include a few figures for an accurate sense of place. As a start, as a pencil guideline, I just drew a simple rectangle just to get the proportion of the monument and help me reduce my subject on the page. And then I painted.
Is the only word I know that suits her well. Quand elle danse et qu'elle met son corps à jour, tel un oiseau qui étend ses ailes pour s'envoler. And when I see her move, I see hell to pay. J'ai posé mes yeux sous sa robe de gitane. And it's no use to pray these prayers to Notre Dame. Tell who'd be the first to raise his hand and throw a stone. I'd hang him high and laugh to see him die alone. Oh Lucifer, oh laisse-moi rien qu'une fois glisser mes doigts dans les cheveux d'Esmeralda.
As you can tell, along with working with a big one each flat brush, I tried not to be too precious with my brush strokes, keeping them almost random, really spontaneous, in order to use them really as shape, graphical elements, rather than a depiction of the monument.
Well, there's a demon inside her who came from hell pour détourner mes yeux du Dieu éternel. He put this heat inside me, I'm ashamed to tell. Pour m'empêcher, not inside, I'm just a burning shell. The sin of Eve she has in her, I know so well. La désirée fait-il de moi un criminel? Laisse-moi rien qu'une fois pousser la porte du jardin d'Esmeralda.
As you can tell, I am not at all counting statues and railings and everything. I'm not even trying to draw gargoyles or anything. This is once again all about making marks that could evoke the essence and the identity of the subject. But of course, the simplification is huge, but because you are not able to get it all, the more you simplify, the better it gets, I think.
Well, even though her eyes seem to lead us to be more pure than words can tell. Quand ses mouvements me font voir monts et merveilles. Beneath her rainbow colored dress, there burns the well. Ma dulcinée, laissez-moi vous être infidèle. Avant de vous avoir mené jusqu'à l'autel. Be the man who turned from her to save his soul. To be with her, I'd let the devil take me home. Oh, fleur de lys, je ne suis pas homme de foi. J'irai cueillir la fleur d'amour d'Esmeralda.
Adding an evocation of the crowd in front of the cathedral, I thought I would work especially on value to strengthen the contrast on the cathedral. And that's when I realized that just putting a bit of a dark blue for dark values wouldn't do the trick for me. So I decided to be bold with the colors, first choosing a cobalt blue so that it gets brighter, and with a bit of opacity, cobalt blue is stronger in color than my previous mix, kind of a gray. grey, blue involving ultramarine, and then why not some red? Hoo-hoo. So the blue was my way of adding a contrast and the darker values, and the red was with my way of brightening the warm colors of Notre Dame. Then I dressed my character with the same color for harmony, and anyway a strong red works always really well for faces and gives a lot of life to your figures. In fact, just throw a few red dashes here and there for heads, arms, hands, and watch your characters appear magically! As I said, I also used some cobalt blue on the figure so that there is a link created between the surrounding and the characters. And as finishing touches, I kept adding some red cheerfulness to my Notre Dame de Paris. Do you think I overworked it a bit? The sketches are bigger than I thought. It's a big A4 sketchbook, so quite large finally, you know, this one has the size of my hand, so that's not so small. So it was the last time I sketched and painted Notre Dame. Yeah, before the fire. But you held on, Notre Dame, I will sketch you again. So let's see what else I can find in my sketchbooks. Oh yeah, I think there is one in this sketchbook as well. Yeah, so with the ink sketch that time, quite a lot of traffic that day in front of Notre Dame. So ink sketch and then using watercolor to once again make the monument light and monument pop on the night sky. Kind of a warm glow of the street lamps. So gorgeous. Maybe some of you are thinking, oh, the sky is orange and red like during the fire, which is quite funny indeed. And in fact, that's because of the street lamp glow I try to evoke, but also because when I am painting by night, you can't really see your colors really well, so you get sometimes a bit of a surprising result. Another surprise in my older sketchbooks. This is called Linear Experimentation November 2015. So this is my linear abstract Notre Dame. I quite like it. I think it's a fun interpretation. So by the way, I am always in Paris in November because this is the Salon de la Photo. So for my work with writing books about photography, I'm in Paris at that time. And so I made a slightly more serious ink interpretation 3 years later. So the same day I painted this kind of a watercolor abstract. Another one I forgot, probably not my best, but this one has a kind of apocalyptic atmosphere and it's a view from behind from the garden, so that's maybe the only one of the sketches when you can indeed see the spike that fell during the fire. So this was kind of, you know, playing with pigment and experimenting with the night atmosphere that day. November 2016. I'm wondering if I sketched Notre Dame every November each year. Maybe not, but probably almost. Here I doodled in Paris, bridge, people, and you can recognize a really small Notre Dame in here. Oh, and finally, there is also this one, which may be my favorite from 2016. I admit that I really like the juiciness and the crazy effect, the looseness, and also the rather off colors, really bright, that are at the same time a personal choice and also due to the condition of the by night painting. I shared this at the time in one of my first video vlog, I guess. Here are a few excerpts, and feel free to watch the whole video if you like.
And now I would like to paint Notre Dame.
I made a bit of progress with my filmmaking since then, and also with my English.
So this is Notre Dame, first step, negative painting with the sky by night. So I did a bit of surrounding trees and the bridge and the Seine, the river. As you can see, I can barely see the colors I am using, so it will be really fun to discover the sketch by day. So just a few lines to make the structure appear. I also added a few dark splatters in the trees, and now I am going to add just a few dark marks on the church to give depth, but I want to keep it really light to make it pop on this night sky. So here it is, once finished. I tried a dark purple on a white building with some yellow marks. I hope it will be okay with the color.
I am so grateful and so glad to know that I will be able to sketch and paint you again Notre Dame de Paris. And I realized this is the third video about this awesome monument, so I even created a playlist gathering my sketching vlog video, and I will keep adding some, as it's always so interesting to search new angles and new techniques and new way to explore an interesting subject. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.